Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. In this video, I want to show you how to conform a timeline using image sequences and EDLs. For this example, we will follow a typical digital intermediate workflow, which will involve using 10-bit log DPX sequences for source media. The two most important pieces of information contained in EDLs are the tape name and timecode of the source media. These two pieces of information need to match the media that you bring into Smoke, or you will not be able to conform the timeline correctly. You need to pay special attention to how you import the media, making sure that you choose the tape and timecode settings correctly to match the EDLs. Let's start off at the Smoke Startup splash screen, where we will create a new project. Creating a new project sets the default values for many of the things you will be doing in Smoke. For example, when you conform an EDL, the resulting timeline will match the project settings by default. So let's call this project EDL Conform. Now this project will be a red 2K project, so I will choose the appropriate setting. The DPX media that I will be using was downscaled from the original red 4K raw data down to 2K DPX sequences. As you know, Smoke can work directly with the original red media, but in this case, we are working in a collaborative environment where many people using different systems will be interacting with the source media. This is very typical for a feature film digital intermediate workflow, as it allows for a streamlined finishing process. This DPX media would typically reside on a shared area network, allowing everybody involved in the process to be able to access the media at any time. These are 10-bit DPX files, so let's choose 10-bit for the bit depth. Now we need to set the configuration template for this project. This refers to the timing and broadcast outputs from the Smoke application. In my case, I am using an HD monitor, so I will choose the HD setting with the desired frame rate. Finally, since I am working with DPX files that will be uncompressed, I will set the project to process in an uncompressed state to keep the image quality. So our settings are set up to match the resolution of our media, and I'll create the project. Now we can launch into Smoke. Okay, so the first steps I'd like to do when setting up to do a conform is to create a few folders in the media library just to be organized from the start. I'll right-click on the default library and choose to create a new folder. I'll call this folder Scans. This will hold all the source media. Now I will duplicate this folder 3 times by pressing Command D. Select the first duplicate and click it to rename the folder. This folder will be called Offlines, and it will contain the reference QuickTime movie I got from Editorial. The next will be called Leaders, and will contain the Academy Leaders. And finally, the last folder will be called Conforms, which will hold our finished sequence. Now let's go ahead and bring in the source media. When I conform EDLs, I like to have all my source media loaded first so that I can link the assembled EDLs to the media right away. Switch to the Media Hub. In the file browser, I will navigate to the location of the DPX files. These DPX sequences have been organized into separate folders. Pay attention to the folder structure. Notice how each sequence is organized into a folder that appears to be the tape name. Smoke allows us to use this folder as the tape name if we decide to. Also, notice the frame numbers of each DPX sequence. These frame numbers are actually timecode values, and Smoke can also use these as source timecodes if we choose. Now it just so happens that these DPX sequences also have embedded metadata. We could use this as well. In the format specific options, set the tape name from header and timecode from header. Whatever you choose, just be sure that it matches the tape names and source timecodes of the EDL. To bring in all the DPX sequences at once, I can simply navigate back up to the parent folder and enable Scan Subdirectories. This option will reveal all the media contained in the subfolders and allow us to import it all at once. You can display these as thumbnails, but I'm going to switch to the list view with a preview window so you can see much more metadata being read in the DPX media. The tape name and timecode is available as a column just to double check. Now make sure all the files are selected by pressing Command A. Click and drag all the selected files into the Scans folder. The default setting is to work native with the media and no caching, so it should be pretty fast. The next thing to import into Smoke are the leaders, so I'll navigate to the folders containing the leaders. Drag the selected clips into the leaders folder. Next, we need the offline reference movie. So once again, I'll navigate through the folder structure to find the offline reference file. This is an HD QuickTime movie file that was exported out of an offline system, so I can do a continuity check once the conform is complete. I'll just add this into the offlines folder. So now we have all our media, and we can now proceed with the conform. Switch to the aptly named Conform tab at the bottom of the interface. Select the Conforms folder in the Media Library and right-click on the main Conform window. Choose Load and Edit a New EDL. This allows us to review the EDL before assembling and to create a multi-layer conform from multiple EDLs. I'll now navigate to the location of the EDLs. So in this folder, we have two EDLs, V1 Scans and V2 Opticals. Opticals is an old term from the film days. If you needed to resize, flop, or even do a simple transition on film, you would need to send it out to an optical house. So in essence, this is a way for editorial to communicate to us that the clips on this V2 EDL need something special to be done to them. The V1 Scan EDL is basically everything else we need to build this conform. I'll select both EDLs and load them into the EDL editor. These are Red 16 EDLs from an Avid, so we will be able to take advantage of the full 16 character tape name. You can see this by the differently colored tape name, and if I click on any of the tape entries, you will be exposed to the full tape name that is written into the EDL. You can also display a tape list if you want. Since we have multiple EDLs loaded, you can switch between the EDLs here to check them. We want to assemble both EDLs into one timeline. To do this, I click and hold down the Assemble button and choose MAssemble for multi-EDL assembly. Here you can choose which EDL becomes which track in the timeline. Just by clicking under the track column, you can assign the correct tracks for each EDL. So the Scans EDL will be Video Track V1, and the Opticals EDL will be Video Track 2. You can also rename the resulting sequence. I'll just click on the entry and remove the Scans tag at the end of the name. To assemble everything together, click the Assemble Selected EDLs button once. Now we exit the multi-assemble and exit the EDL editor. So here is our conform, and the clip is in the media library. The assembled sequence is displayed as a timeline at the bottom, and as a list of sources in the conform list. After you assemble the EDL, the next step is to link the result to the corresponding source media. Change the matching criteria of the conform tool to search for media only based on tape name and timecode. Make sure you turn off the other criteria so Smoke stops considering them when scanning for media. Now you need to tell Smoke where to find the sources. Select the Scans folder and right-click on it. Choose Set as Conform Search Location. This means that this folder and all of its contents will be scanned as possible matches for the conform. The highlights indicate that Smoke has found matches for the scans based on tape name and timecode. And the status column updates with tick indicators showing the matches. Now click on the drop-down arrow and link matched sources. This will take all the potential matches and link them to the sequence. As expected, the head and tail leaders are still unlinked. That is because these sources were not in the scans folder. We will be dropping these in manually, so this is not a problem for us right now. In the next video, we'll add the leaders and perform the continuity check to ensure everything lines up within the edit. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.